Hey everyone, let's dive straight into a bit of a royal whirlwind today. The royal sphere is buzzing with the recent release of Omid Scobie's book, Endgame. Now, this isn't just any book release. The controversy is at an all-time high, primarily because of a pretty sensitive topic. It mentions the names of two royal family members who reportedly made remarks about Archie's skin color before he was even born. Can you believe that? There's a thick cloud of mystery and suspicion surrounding the book, especially regarding Meghan and Harry's role in its creation. They've tried to keep their distance, but let's face it, that's not convincing everyone. Scobie himself is in the hot seat. He's playing the I don't know card about how these names got into his book, but guess what? He had mentioned them earlier too. So, it's no surprise that eyebrows are raised. Despite all the drama, this big revelation didn't really skyrocket the book's sales. What's more intriguing is waiting to see how the palace, Meghan and Harry, are going to deal with these bombshell allegations. Many of you have this hunch, and it does make sense, that Meghan could be the one spilling the beans. After all, she's had her share of controversies. Remember the leaked letters to her father? But here's a twist. Kinsey Schofield, who's pretty clued up about these royal matters, throws in this fascinating fan theory. It suggests that Meghan might be playing a clever game. The theory goes like this. Meghan allows some juicy details to slip into Scobie's book, creating a prelude to her own book. This way, when she dives into these topics herself, it won't be a total shocker, and she can avoid the brunt of a major reveal. If this is true, it's a smart way for Meghan to lay down her narrative on her own terms. So, what do you make of this royal puzzle? Is Meghan orchestrating her own story through Scobie's book, or is it just a series of coincidences? The plot definitely thickens in the world of the royals. All right, let's keep unraveling this royal tapestry. The key thing to remember here is that all of this, the theories, the speculations, it's like putting together a jigsaw puzzle without all the pieces. We're trying to make sense of the motivations and origins behind the bombshells in Scobie's book, but honestly, it's a bit of a head-scratcher. Now, you're probably wondering about Meghan and Harry's dance with the media and their royal ties. It's like a chess game, right? There's a lot of skepticism out there, especially about Meghan. Some of you might think she's got a knack for stirring the pot and then stepping back as if she had nothing to do with it. This whole situation with Scobie's book, it's adding fuel to that fire. Think about it. If Meghan is indeed behind the leak of those names, it's a clever move. She might be thinking ahead to her own book, where she can delve deeper into these topics. It's like she's setting the stage, isn't it? If those names hadn't been revealed now, they would have been a bombshell in her own book. But now, it's like she's softened the ground for whatever she's planning to discuss. This whole saga also shines a light on Meghan and Harry's complex relationship with the media and their image management. They're super protective of their privacy, yet they're often caught up in situations that poke into others' private lives. It's a bit of a contradiction, don't you think? And then there's this angle. How did Scobie get his hands on this info? The idea that he could have got it from their close friends without Meghan and Harry's knowledge seems a bit far-fetched. These two are known for keeping a tight lid on their personal narrative. So even if Scobie didn't get the scoop directly from them, could their reps be involved? It's a possibility that ties back to them, one way or another. So what's your take? Are Meghan and Harry pulling the strings behind the scenes? Or is this just a series of unexpected leaks and revelations? It's a royal conundrum that keeps getting more intriguing. So let's peel back another layer of this royal drama. Meghan and Harry have a bit of a history when it comes to shaping their media narrative. They're all for positive stories, but when it comes to negative press, not so much. This approach throws a spotlight on their potential involvement in Scobie's book. It's like a game of shadows and mirrors, isn't it? Here's a thought many of you might be sharing. Can Meghan and Harry really wash their hands off the content in Endgame? The court of public opinion seems to think that, one way or another, they've played a part in this whole saga and the image painted in the book. pettiness, immaturity, isn't doing them any favors. It's like watching their reputation take hit after hit. Now, this is where it gets really spicy. Could this be a grand scheme by Meghan, Harry, and Scobie to shake the very foundations of the monarchy? It sounds like something out of a thriller novel, right? This theory could point to deeper intentions, maybe even a rift that's beyond repair with the royal family. Speaking of rifts, let's talk about the possible fallout from all this. Endgame might just be the final nail in the coffin for any hope of reconciliation between Meghan and Harry and the rest of the royals. Imagine if the royal family decides to investigate and proves their involvement in the book. That could be the endgame for their royal ties. Pun intended, King Charles and the royal family aren't losing sleep over Scobie, but they're not exactly fans either. They see him more like a distraction, someone stirring the pot while they're trying to focus on positive initiatives. This is about the monarchy trying to maintain its dignity and focus amidst all this drama. Elisa Anderson, a former royal press secretary, shed some light on this. The real fear here is the unknown. What else could be lurking in Scobie's book? While it's unlikely to topple the monarchy, the lack of clarity and the timing of its release amidst other major global events certainly adds an element of unease. So, where does all this leave us? Is Endgame just a storm in a teacup, or does it have the power to change the royal narrative forever? The plot thickens and the royal saga continues.